Grammar TV 27, a platform of truth, justice, and righteousness. Let the truth be told. TV 27 here, the founder of Loop D&G. We're standing here in Uptown's Memorial Garden, Camp Curtin Memorial Garden, you know, founded by the Reverend James Lyles, Youth 10 Times Better. We're standing here, this is where a lot of our people in our community have lost their lives due to gun violence. And we're doing a lot of work in the community. So brother, what the Reverend James Lyles has put this there for as a reminder of what's going on in our communities, and we have to pick up that baton where some of them leave off. So explain to us, man, the importance and the effects of gun violence, because I'm sure you know someone, I know someone that has been a victim of gun violence in our community.
I mean, it's like what you were saying earlier, in particular, that, you know, we could do everything we want to do as far as, you know, promoting the right thing about gun laws. But the actual thing, like everything else, starts at home. We need to govern our own kids as opposed to telling them and saying to them, look, guns are not the key, okay? There's a right way of going about things and there's wrong. And that's the thing, you know, the government don't care at all.
That's right.
You know what I mean? They're politicking and doing all these different things right now to solidify what, you know, they believe about what gun laws should be and what they shouldn't be. And I'm just saying, the bottom line is this: we need to govern our own kids.
That's right.
We need to allow them to know that what guns are harmful, you know, and it basically, in a way, in a sense that we have been using them over the period of time.
Right.
But in retrospect, when you take a kid out and show him how to hunt, take him out into nature and different things like that, that's when they, you know, when the kids, you know, should
thrive to
should be able to use
enjoy
and in a proper way. See, and what happens when they use guns in the wrong way, it comes back later to haunt them because they can't buy a gun because of their prior record.
Right.
See, and that keeps our kids from being able to be individuals who learn how to live off the land and different things like that.
Right.
Show them nature things.
Right.
I mean, just recently we took the kids down to Wyoming.
Right.
And sure enough, each one of them had a chance to have target practice and everything.
Yes.
With a gun.
And bow and arrows.
And of course,
archery.
Archery. They got to experience what it's like.
Right.
And if I'm not mistaken, I believe one of the staff was saying that was from Wyoming, said, this is what we should do with youth more often, and
right.
Then you would find that they're not out killing each other once they learn
right.
The right perspective about love, I mean, about guns.
That's right. So I want to ask you this. I heard you say something while you were speaking due to the government. Now, this may sound cliche, but guns don't kill people. People do.
That's right.
So do you think that there is a law that can be written to eradicate gun violence? Or does the work have to come to the people?
The law is already written.
Right.
See, the one key thing is the law is already written divinely. Divine. You see what I'm saying? It's a law that we disregard altogether, and that law is governed by God. See, God's laws talks about all these laws that's contrary to his law.
Right.
That's not right. So when you talk about governing, are you talking about what?
Or policy.
Policies and different things like that. That don't mean nothing. And like you said before, is it going to stop the killing? No, it has not stopped the killing. Okay? But at the same time, we can educate our kids properly.
Right.
You see, and that's the key thing. It ain't about if it's a gun law, if it's not a gun law.
Right.
Because regardless, it has been gun laws, and guess what? The city and everywhere else in the world is being flooded
with guns
that's not registered.
And not even manufactured here.
When you do that, when the government do that, guess what happens? It brings forth more death. Why? Because now you got people stealing guns. Or you got stolen guns that's bought in there in the city, which has been doing that for years.
And more people may seem the need to have one. Like, I better have my gun because everybody else got them. And which brings on more violence. No, you can't settle a situation by having a conversation. I have to blow you off the earth to end it.
Exactly. And now I'm glad you brought that up. See, back when, you know, when we were growing up, they would make you on the bullhorn tell you to lay on the ground, right? Lay down, get out the car, hands up, lay down. There was a certain policy to, you know, how you do things, how the cop rolled up on you, or how, even if it was two officers in the same car, they would get on the bullhorn, make you lay down, flat. That means you're not on your feet. That means you're not in a position where you could even in a position to run or anything like that, to do anything physically that they would make you suspicious of a gun or anything like that to shoot you and kill you.
Right.
So, I mean, don't get me wrong. I think they should go back to that.
Right.
But in the same breath of respect, this is what I'm talking about. You know, the politicians want to talk about everything else, but they don't want to talk about exercising something that will change and make change and what will cause death will cause life.
Okay. So at the end of the day, in a perfect world, what is a perfect world for Luke B and G?
Man, a perfect world is this. And I say it like this. In St. John chapter 14, in 27 verse, God says, my peace I give unto you, my peace I leave with you. Not as the world give unto you, that I give unto you. Let not your heart be troubled, but neither let it be afraid. And just let me say that again. My peace I leave with you, my peace I give unto you. Not as the world give unto you, do I give unto you. Let not your heart be troubled, but neither let it be afraid.
All right. Dr. Anthony Renette, founder of Loop D&G, Youth 10 Times Better, Breaking the Change, Drama TV 27.